Marie Antoinette was born on the 2nd of November 1755. She was born Maria Antonia Josepha Johanna at the Hofburg Palace in Vienna. She became an Archduchess of Austria, and was the penultimate child of Empress Maria Theresa, ruler of the Habsburg Empire, and Francis I, Holy Roman Emperor. Her godparents were Joseph I and Mariana Victoria, King and Queen of Portugal. Her relationship with her mother, the Empress Maria Theresa, would be a difficult one, but they would always love each other.
Soon after birth, she was placed under the care of Countess von Brandeis, the governess of the imperial children, including her older sister Maria Carolina, with whom she would have a lifelong close relationship.
Maria Antonia spent her early years either at Hofburg Palace and the imperial summer residence Schönbrunn in Vienna. It was at Schönbrunn that Maria, at the age of 7, met Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, 2 months her junior and a child prodigy, on the 13th of October 1762. The results of her schooling were poor despite receiving private tutoring. By the age of 10, she could not master writing in German or in other common court languages such as French and Italian. Maria Antonia did, though, develop into a good musician under the tuition of Christoph Willibald Gluck, mastering the harp, the harpsichord, and the flute, as well as excelling at dancing. She also sang regularly when in family met in the evening, possessing a beautiful voice. After the 7 Years' War and the diplomatic revolution of 1756, Empress Maria Theresa decided to sue for peace with her enemy, King Louis XV of France. To secure peace and curb the ambitions of Prussia and Great, led them to seal their alliance through marriage. Louis XV formally requested the hand of Maria Antonia for his heir and oldest living grandson, Louis-Auguste, the Dauphin of France, on the 7th of February 1770.
She finally met her husband at the Forest of Compiègne on the 14th of May.
She took on her French name, Marie Antoinette, on her arrival in France. A ceremonial wedding took place at the Palace of Versailles on the 16th of May 1770, and after the festivities, the day was due to end with a ritual consummation. The lack of a marriage consummation plagued both Louis-Auguste and Marie Antoinette for the first 7 years of their marriage.
Marie Antoinette and Louis-Auguste's marriage was initially met with mixed reaction from the French population. Marie Antoinette was well liked by the common people because of her beauty and her successful first official appearance in Paris on the 8th of June 1773. But there were people who detested the Austrian alliance, and there were those who had a difficult relationship with Marie Antoinette due to conflict in personalities. Madame du Barry, Louis XV's mistress and had considerable influence over Dauphin. Madame du Barry was involved in the removal of Étienne François, Duc de Choiseul, who was one of the architects of the Franco-Austrian alliance and Marie Antoinette's marriage. Madame du Barry also exiled the Duc de Choiseul's sister, the Duchess de Grandmont, who was one of Marie Antoinette's ladies-in-waiting. Her husband's aunts persuaded Marie Antoinette to refuse to acknowledge du Barry, which was seen by some as a political miscalculation that threatened Austria's interests at the French court. The Austrian ambassador to France, Comte de Mercy Argenta, who was sending Marie Antoinette's mother secret reports on her daughter's behavior at court. The Empress and the ambassador applied pressure on Marie Antoinette to speak to Madame du Barry, which she reluctantly agreed to do on New Year's Day 1772. Marie Antoinette simply mentioned to Madame du Barry, There are a lot of people at Versailles today, but it was enough for King's mistress, who was content with this acknowledgement, and the crisis passed. Immediately after the death of Louis XV in 1774, Louis XVI sent Madame du Barry into exile at the Abbaye de Pont aux Dames in Meaux, to the pleasure of both his wife and aunts. 2.5 years later, at the end of October 1776, Madame du Barry's exile was over and she was allowed to return to her much-loved chateau at Louvain, but she was never allowed to return to Versailles.